In the previous video, we have introduced an alternative to semiconductor-based PV, namely organic PV. OPV consists of organic molecules or polymer chains. We have discussed the basic chemistry and quantum mechanical principles that are required to understand why organic molecules can exhibit the photovoltaic effect. In this video, we will continue with bonding of organic molecules, and we will see how this can result in charge carrier transport from one molecule to another. Secondly, we will introduce the organic material equivalent to the valence and conduction band, and you will learn how these energy levels are formed. Let's take carbon as an example. The spatial arrangement of the p orbital of carbon is shown here. As we have shown in the previous video, the electron configuration of carbon is 2s2 2p2. The three 2p orbitals are called the 2px, 2pi and 2pz orbitals. When carbon forms a covalent bond with, for instance, hydrogen, the electron in one orbital is shared with an electron in the orbital of hydrogen to complete the octet and form a molecule. This would mean that carbon can only make covalent bonds with no more than two hydrogen atoms, since it only has two valence electrons. This, however, is not true. If we take the example of methane, which is a simple hydrocarbon, we notice that four hydrogen atoms bond with one carbon atom. This can be explained by the theory of orbital hybridization. This theory explains that the outer S and P shells mix with each other to form hybrid orbitals. All these hybrid orbitals have the same energy level. In this case, to maintain Hund's law of multiplicity, one of the two electrons in the 2s orbital is excited and moves into the last sp orbital. This now allows the four sp hybrid orbitals to share their electron with a single electron in the 1s orbital of the hydrogen. Consequently, carbon can bond with four hydrogen atoms. Similarly, ethane, with a molecular formula of C2H6, has two carbon atoms bonded to each other and two 3 hydrogen atoms each. These covalent bonds are called sigma bonds and are formed by the direct overlap of two orbitals. If all of the lone pair electrons, so all the valence electrons, in the carbon atom form sigma bonds, the hydrocarbon molecule is called a saturated hydrocarbon. Unsaturated molecules, on the other hand, like ethane, which has the molecular formula C2H4, have one or more free p orbitals on each atom. This leads to the formation of less than four sp hybrid orbitals that can bond with other atoms to form a sigma bond. The empty p orbital of both carbon atoms bond with each other to form a weaker pi bond. This way, the electrons in these p orbitals are shared between each other. Pi bonds are the basis for charge carrier transport in organic photovoltaic materials. OPV therefore only works with unsaturated hydrocarbons. Complex organic molecules may contain several carbon atoms with an alternating single and double or triple bonded carbon atom, with every atom having at least one p orbital empty. This results in a continuous pi bond formation between neighboring carbon atoms throughout the chain, resulting in a network of interlinked p orbitals that can share their electrons. This allows the movement of electrons from one end of the molecule to the other. This is how charge carrier transport occurs in organic molecules. In another example, benzene, with an empirical formula of C6H6, has alternating double bonds in its structure. It denotes the presence of free unbonded p orbitals on neighboring carbon atoms. Due to their unbonded nature, the p orbitals of the carbon atoms will start to intermix. This intermixing of these empty pz orbitals therefore results in the formation of one big delocalized pi orbital. This delocalization of the pz orbitals allows for the free movement of charge carriers. This means that in the intermixed p orbital, charge carrier transport is possible. This sideways intermixing of p orbitals can occur either constructively or destructively. Let's first look at the constructive intermixing. The constructive intermixing of these orbitals give rise to a delocalized pi orbital with a lower energy. Destructive intermixing, on the other hand, gives rise to an antibonding pi state with a higher energy level. This destructive and constructive intermixing splitting of molecular orbitals is what forms the band gap in such organic molecules. The lower energy state is preferred by electrons and is occupied under normal room temperature conditions. This energy state is called the highest occupied molecular orbital, or HOMO. The higher energy state, which is relatively unoccupied, is called the lowest unoccupied molecular orbital, or LUMO. The HOMO is therefore equivalent to the valence band edge in semiconductors, and the LUMO is equivalent to the conduction edge. This is how organic materials can show semiconductor-like properties. To summarize this video, we have explored the mechanism of carrier transport in organic photovoltaics through bonding of unsaturated hydrocarbons. Delocalized pi orbitals and the consequent formation of molecular orbitals is caused by the constructive and destructive overlap of the pz orbitals. This in turn gives rise to energy states equivalent to the valence and conduction band in inorganic semiconductor materials. This helps us to define the band gap in these materials. In the next video, we will look at an organic heterojunction solar cell.